You all appreciate it.
This is 13 miles in. I was looking for a short day. It's 10 minutes till 3. Let's take a look at the shelter. Oh, it's on and cracking. We got a fire pit. If you think I'm not gonna make a fire, you don't know ARP. Huh. Okay. Here's the shelter. It has a loft, so I'm pitching my tent in this mother and I'm doing it in the loft. I'm at the Hemlock. If I wanted to, I can kill some time and run down to the lake, but I'm good. I'd rather make a fire. As you can see, it's very well manicured. I'll tell you what, I stepped in more water today and I think it had nothing to do with the previous rain. There's just more streams in, where am I, Minnesota? No, Massachusetts. There's more creeks in Massachusetts, but the good thing is you can drink out of every single one of them, so I am not hurting for water right now. Speaking of which, I need to figure out where the nearest stream is. All right, out here, let's make a fire. You know how we do it. The day before yesterday, I did 16 miles to a town called Salisbury, and that's where I got picked up, and I went to Bears in the Woods, Bearded Woods Hostel. The following day, which is today, I did 13 miles to this shelter. Tomorrow, I'm going to do 16 miles to a place called East Mountain Retreat. Now, if it appears by my actions that I'm dragging my feet and not doing my customary 20 plus miles, it's because it's true. A couple days back, someone following my videos on YouTube sent me a Facebook message saying that he and his wife would like to send me a care package. Would I like that? And if so, where could they send it? Well, my response was, hell yeah. And I looked at the book, you know, real quickly, and I pulled an address out, and then I emailed him the address, and then he sent back, okay, you know, package in the mail. All right, so that made it real when he said he sent it. So I went back to the book and I started looking, and right now at this moment, I'm at mile marker 1513. The package is being sent to a place called Shamrock Inn at mile marker 1569. And that's when I made the realization of, oh,
I may have to drag my feet a bit because I don't know where they hail from. I don't know if he sent it UPS and if he sent it regular mail. You know, I should have gave it a little bit more thought. So I'm dragging my feet just a tad so I don't get there too soon. Because a couple of, you know, 20 mile days, a 30, I can blow right past that. All right. So yeah. And you know what? I'm enjoying the experience. It's not about, and this is true enough. It's not about the miles. It's about the smiles, as they say, as cliche as it sounds. But it is true. I mean, the hostel was great. You know what I'm saying? That in the 16 miles I did to Salisbury was cool. I mean, it was a quaint town. The point I'm trying to make is, even though I'm dragging my feet, I'm still seeing things and I'm still meeting people that I wouldn't have otherwise met. Okay? So, I'm going to check out this retreat. And this retreat should be a lot like Mount Vernon. The one I showed you with the hostel that had the open kitchen and there was nobody there. It was a ghost town. $10 donation. That's what this is. So what I'm going to do is, yeah, I'm just going to slide in there, 16 miles tomorrow, slide in there, see what's up, take a shower, you know, and maybe I'll stay. I mean, like I said, I'm just chilling just a tad, dragging my feet just a bit. So yeah, that's pretty much, you know, it's not that I'm hurting. It's not that the terrain is so bad. Taking it easy, so to speak. Somebody's coming and just threw off my my concentration. As you can see, I'm alone, but I'm not anymore because some guys just popped in and I don't want to appear as if I'm crazy, so out here. Good morning. Had the shelter to myself last night. You know what the plan is. We're gonna knock out 16 miles. We're gonna go to East Mountain Retreat Center. We're gonna order some pizza, take a shower, and I need to address these boots. Believe it or not, they're on their last legs. I mean, it's like I said before, I should have got the cross stitch, but they're about to open up. And then once they do that, they become dangerous because they will cause you to trip. And that's not a good thing. So I got some super glue. I'm gonna try to see what I can do with that again, but that'll only hold for so long. It's a temporary fix. I took another look at it as far as the using a needle, a hot needle and thread to sear it up. And all I'm gonna do is compromise the leather by punching a hole through it. And when I do that, it's gonna compromise the fit of the boot because of the curvature of the toe. Anyway, all I'm saying is the time's gonna come where I'm gonna have to get some new boots sooner than later. And just, you know, let that be a lesson. I knew better, but hey, don't compromise. If you know what the standard is, don't compromise. Either go without or don't come back until you get it right. It's just basically the best I can say. And in the end, you'll be the better for it because you won't be wasting money out here. This is that time in the day where the light hits just so. It's beautiful, everything is sparkling. The trees are different here. They're not birch, they're tall pine. You feel like Goldilocks. Back in the military, I used to tell the white guys that would ask, why is it you never get prickly heat or poison ivy or blah, blah, blah? And I would just look at him and say, black people don't get those things. But then there was a time in 2008, actually, where I was walking. Well, I was on the trail doing hike and all that. I went to a hostel. I took a shower. And after I got out of the shower, my legs were just burning. I mean, it felt like 1,000 pins being stuck, you know? And then I reached to touch my legs and they were just sensitive. And it was like, I just wanted to just scratch my skin off. So I immediately got back in the shower. I turned the water on all hot. And then I got into it and I felt this relief, you know? If you've ever had athlete's foot or some kind of fungal infection and you put hot water on it, it feels so good. It's like it's supposed to burn, but it doesn't. It's just like a point of equilibrium, almost ecstasy. But anyway, I sat there and I let the hot water just bake my legs. And then I started thinking this couldn't be healthy, even though it felt good. So I turned off the shower. And when I tried to dry myself with the towel, once the water evaporated, again, it's just 1,000 pins. And I gotta tell you, it took all my willpower not to just scratch my skin off. And then I started thinking, not then, this was like months later, even years later, I started thinking, could that have been poison ivy and I just didn't scratch it, you know? And ever since then, it happened in 2008. Ever since then, even now, I'd be hiking, because you see how I am. My legs are exposed. It always happens when I take a shower and I clean myself up. I get out the shower and I just feel this intense, you know, but I see it now. I believe I see it for what it is. Maybe I do have poison ivy, or I get poison ivy, but the difference is I don't scratch. Or maybe it's the melanin in a dark person's skin that makes it such that right on the precipice of scratching, they don't have to. They can almost will it away. And I'll give it that as opposed to anything else. But I guess you can get poison ivy out here, because there is nothing I've ever experienced like that. And sometimes it happens on the arms or on my hands or something. But yeah, there are, well, what's the point in this? I'm telling you, if you're hiking in shorts and stuff like that, you can't help but to brush against this stuff. Sometimes the maintainers do a good job. Other times, it'll just come out and grab you. And before you know it, you're covered in who knows what. And it's gonna affect you, you know? If you got the willpower not to scratch, more power to you. But you're gonna be exposed to something out here. And I tell you what, man, it's something else. Anyway, out here. I've never seen this before. These are sheep, not cows. Check it out, real sheep, not llamas. Dude, are those testicles? Look at that, that is amazing. Or maybe that's an udder. Holy. Bigger than a bull's. So these are sheep. I wonder if they, yeah, I'm sure they do shave them, sell the wool. All right, it's official. I've seen enough of them. Those are actual testicles. I swear to God, those things are huge. Or maybe it's just the fur that makes them appear to be so big. There you have it. Mystery solved. The mosquitoes decided to attack as soon as I hit the brown wood. It's terrible. I had to drop my pants and everything. Really bad. Point 1.5, we'll just say 0.2 miles from the trail, there's that place right there. They sell soda pops. Listen to me, soda pops. They sell soda and suckers. So $2 got me a ginger ale and two suckers. I'm 8 miles away from the retreat center. I took another look at the book, and that retreat center, the street that takes you to it, is 3 miles from town, and there's a subway there. So what I'm gonna do is, when I hit that road, I'm gonna hitch into town, get some subway, hitch out of town, and then hit the retreat. We'll talk about it later out here. Back in mosquito country. That water looks good. I think I'm gonna have a drink. And by the way, when I say looks good, I don't mean like it's a good source. I mean, it looks tasty. If you ever want to taste a mountain, this is how you do it out here. Look at the clarity. No orange hue, nothing like that. And I assure you, it tastes excellent out here. This is Checkpoint Alpha. I'm 2 miles away from my terminus, the road, and East Mountain. East Mountain Retreat Center. Yeah. How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Great, so dark. A big cavern. Massachusetts is not without its swamps, bogs, and mud traps, but I gotta tell you, it's beautiful. You've seen it, the rocks, the stone basins, the clear, fresh water, and the trail. It takes upon different aspects. One time you're you know, traversing rocky ledges. Next, you're going through cavernous rocks. Next, you're in vast trail like this. Interesting thing about being stationed in Germany is I've had the opportunity to visit the whole of Europe. The first place I ever traveled to was Paris, not counting Germany. The last place in being stationed in Germany for 2 years was Amsterdam. And call me crazy, but Amsterdam had a piece of every single place in Europe that I saw. Amsterdam has their own Palace of Versailles that almost matches brick for brick what's in Paris. And then they got the water to like rival, like the water canals to rival Venice in Italy. They got the cobblestone streets that reminds me of like London. I mean, it's just, when I was there, I was just like, man, I've seen this. It's like deja vu all through Amsterdam. And then it had the little kick of the red light district and drugs and all that. But the point I'm trying to say is that Massachusetts is like the Amsterdam of the trail. It has a bit of everything, you know? It has a bit of New York in it, Connecticut, Georgia, North Carolina. With the exception of the mosquitoes, but you know, you can't have everything, right? Massachusetts may become my new favorite state if I just had to pick one. Because I'll tell you something else about Massachusetts. You find yourself stepping out the trail onto like people's front yards or majestic streets like Boston. And you just saw it just a second ago. I came out the street and there was this little place there where I got something to drink. Anyway, maybe I'm babbling, but Massachusetts is cool. It's been redeemed. Because I got to tell you, this was the place that kicked me off the trail. The mosquitoes were so bad and I couldn't come back without a tent. But that just warrants respect, if anything. Out here. This road marks the terminus, 16 miles. If I go down this way, I'm gonna go to the retreat center. I can also hitch into town going this way. Maybe go to Subway or something. The retreat itself is 1 mile this way. So let's get cracking out here. Okay, I hitched in. The person that picked me up, we did a recon. So I know exactly where the hostel is when I'm coming back, but it's not close at all. You gotta walk a mile and a half. This is the town of Great Brewerton or whatever. I was gonna go to Subway and then I took another look at the map and there's a McDonald's there and it's closer. So I'm gonna walk up to McDonald's, chill for a minute, then come back down here and hitch back out to the shelter. Out here. I want a frappuccino or a frappe. One of those caramel latte kind of deals. I'm gonna take a drink while I compose myself. Work on this computer for a second. Out here. Well, this is the retreat. It's not surprising that I'm the only person here. It's kind of what I expect. To be honest with you, I just expect to be the only person everywhere I go. It's not much to it. Check out the bunkhouse, right? Yeah. Oh, this is cool. Okay. This is a common area. You got a hot plate. You got a library, which is good because I need a book. This is the bathroom. The shower. I'm looking forward to that. Okay. All right, this is it in a nutshell. I believe it's 5:30. I actually got in town around 3, and I should have mentioned that. I try to keep a timestamp so you see how good I'm doing. Or, you know. Yeah, okay, I'm going to play with this computer. They don't have Wi-Fi here, but that's not stopping me from making some movies. So I'm going to make a few movies, and next time I hit some internet, pump them up. I'm going to take a shower and just relax, chill. My day's over with. Out here. Believe it or not, it's actually raining. I guess I just made it. This is crazy the way that it keeps raining. Wow, it's amazing. Hey, check this out. I want to tell you something. When I was looking at the particulars in the book, I noticed that it said, the book said, that the pizza people will deliver here. So what I did was I hitched into town. And then the first pizzeria I came to, I said, check this out. If I do an order, can I ride that order out to this location? Anyway, they had to talk to their manager and all that, but they said yes. So what I said was, all right, I'll be with you guys later. Because basically, here's the deal. I wasn't going to give any pizzeria my business that wasn't going to give me a ride out. Once they made the commitment, then I went on ahead and did whatever I had to do in town. You saw me, I went to McDonald's and all that. On the way back, I placed my order right here. I got a calzone, I got a salad, 2 liter Pepsi, 2 liter Sprite, and then I got in the car with them and they dropped me off back at my location. Point I'm trying to make is leverage the situation, always, okay? Because you have the money, you have the power. Ain't no sense in ordering something and then hitching with it. That doesn't make any sense. And in some cases, even if they don't deliver,
I'm a mile and a half away. They don't know where this place is, or if they don't know where you're going, if they want your business, they'll give you a ride. Just, you know, think about it. That's all. Out here.